This video will explain how to analyze results from two triaxial tests. And instead of drawing more circles, we're just going to use a formula and do a very quick calculations. Let's look at these examples when we have results from two tests, test one, test two. We have confining pressure, which is sigma 3. And we have a deviator stress at failure, which is in this case 173. And we are required to find the shear strength parameters of this soil. So probably the simple and the easiest way, well, maybe not the easiest, but the simple way is to draw two circles, Mohr column circles. So in this case, we need to know sigma 3. And it's given here in this column. And then we need to find sigma 1, which is sigma 3 plus the deviator stress. So for test number 1, you will see that sigma 1 will be 70 plus 173, and that will give us 243 kilonewtons per square meters. And for the second test, you will see that sigma 1 at failure will be 105 plus 235. It will be 340 kilonewtons per square meters. So what we'll do next is we will draw a Mohr circle for each test. So for the first test, sigma 3 will be 70, and it's already drawn here. I'll look at this schematic diagram, which is actually drawn to scale. Don't forget to use units. And here we also use units, kilonewtons per square meters. So for the first circle, sigma 3 is here, 70, sigma 3. And sigma 1 is, will be here, which is 243. And then we use drawing compass and we draw a circle. And we do the same procedure for the second test. Then we'll have sigma 3, which is 105 kilonewtons per square meters. And sigma 1 will be 340. We draw a bigger circle. Then we draw a failure envelope. Failure envelope should be tangent towards circles. And then we're going to find this friction angle, phi, and this distance will be cohesion. So you can still do that. It's a good exercise, but I'm going to show you another, I would probably say, simple and easy way to find cohesion and friction angle for these two tests without drawing circles. So we'll need to use this equation, and this equation works for effective stress conditions. You'll see this means effective stress conditions. And what we're going to do, we're going to write this equation for both tests. So let's say we'll do it for the first one. We're going to write that sigma 1 at failure is going to be 243 equal sigma 3 is this 170 times tangent in the power of 2, 45 plus phi divided by 2 plus 2 times cohesion times tangent 45 degrees plus friction angle divided by 2. And we'll do the same thing for the second test. So in this case, the principal stress at failure will be 340. And sigma 3, it's 105. And the rest is the same as in the first test. So I'll just copy it. And we have two equations and we have two unknowns, so we can easily solve this one. So the technique that I'm going to use, I'm going to subtract equation 1 from equation 2, so 2 minus 1. So in this case we have 340 minus 243, that will be 97. And then we have 105 minus 40 will give us 35 of tangent in the power of 2 plus friction angle divided by 2. Why did I do that? So that I can get rid of this component here, because it's the same in both equations. So now we can easily solve this simple equation. So I'll just show you steps, just in case if some of you still don't know how to do that. So 97 divided by 35 will be about 2.77 equal tangent in the power of 2, 45 plus friction angle divided by 2. So then you see we have here power of 2. So we need to take a square root of 2.77, and that will be 1.66, which will be just tangent of 45 plus friction angle divided by 2. Tangent of 1.66 is approximately 58.9 degrees, equal 45 degrees plus friction angle divided by 2. And from here we're going to find that friction angle is approximately 27.8 degrees. Okay, so what we do next, we're going to use this friction angle, and we're going to put it in one of the equations, either number 1 or number 2, and then we just solve it against the cohesion. And if you do that, you should be able to find the cohesion for effective stress conditions will be approximately 14.8 kilonewton per square meters. Thanks for watching this video. If you like it, please put likes and subscribe for the channel. Have a nice day. Bye.